Using the Python debugger in a terminal. In this video, we'll learn how to use the Python debugger in a terminal. For this example, we're running code from the token classification section, downloading the QNL dataset before loading a tokenizer to preprocess it. Check out the section of the course linked below for more information. Once this is done, we try to batch together some features of the training dataset by padding them and returning a tensor. If we try to execute our scripts in a terminal, we get an error. Note that we use PyTorch here with return tensors equal pt, but you would get the same error with TensorFlow. As we have seen in the How to Debug an Error video, the error message is at the end, and it indicates we should use padding, which we are actually trying to do. So this is not useful and we need to go a little deeper to debug the problem. Fortunately, you can use the Python debugger quite easily in a terminal by launching your script with python -m pdb and then the name of the training script. When executing that command, you are sent to the first instruction of your script. You can run just the next instruction by tapping N and enter, or you can continue directly to the error by typing C and enter. Once there, you go to the very bottom of the traceback and you can type commands. The first two commands you should learn are U and D for up and down. This allows you to get up and down in the traceback. Going up twice, we get to the point the error was reached. The third command to learn is P for print. It allows you to print any value you want. For instance, here we can see the value of return tensors, or batch outputs to try to understand what triggered the error. The batch outputs dictionary is a bit hard to see, so let's dive into smaller pieces of it. Inside the debugger, you can not only print any variable but also evaluate any expression, so we can look independently at the inputs or the labels. Those labels are definitely weird. They are of various size, which we can confirm by printing the size using a list comprehension. No wonder the tokenizer wasn't able to create a tensor with them. This is because the pad method only takes care of the tokenizer outputs, the input IDs, the attention mask, and the token type IDs. So we have to pad the label ourselves before trying to create a new tensor with them. Once you're ready to exit the Python debugger, you can press Q for quit and enter. Another way we can access the Python debugger is to put a breaking point in our script. We can do this using the pdb.setTrace method, as long as we import the PDB module at the beginning of our script. Saving and then relaunching our script with just Python, we'll stop the execution at the breaking point we set. We can inspect all the variables before the next instruction is executed again. For instance, here, the features. Typing N and enter executes the next instruction, which takes us back inside the traceback. One way to fix the error manually is to pad all the labels to the longest. Another way is to use the data collator suitable for token classification. If you want to learn how to use the Python debugger in a notebook, check out the video linked below.